Hello everyone, Mauro here. In this video, we're going to look at the new features and changes that Microsoft is rolling out with the June 2025 update for Windows 11 version 24H2. It's important to mention that Microsoft rolls out new features and changes gradually, so updating your computer to the latest release doesn't guarantee that you will see the improvements right away. Also, stay tuned until the end because I'm going to show you how to get this update on your computer. Okay, let's dive into what's new in June 2025 for Windows 11. But before we start, make sure to subscribe and hit the like button. It helps a lot to grow the channel and continue with this project. Also, check out my website for more tutorials and related tech news. So just a quick note, I was planning to record this video on an actual Copilot Plus PC to show you the changes for Click to Do and Windows Recall, but these features are currently not working on my computer, so I'm in the process of resetting the device, and I'm going to have to improvise on how to show you the changes for the AI features. Now, in the June 2025 update, Microsoft is adding the ability to use a Windows C keyboard shortcut to open the Copilot app on the desktop. You can always change this behavior from Settings, Personalization, Text Input, and using the Customized Copilot Key on Keyboard Option. In addition, the Copilot app also introduces a Press to Talk feature, which you can invoke by holding the Windows key plus C or the Alt plus Spacebar keyboard shortcut for 2 seconds. So, for example, if you use a Windows C keyboard shortcut, that would actually open Copilot. However, if you press and hold the Windows key plus C, it will open the voice mode. In this release, Microsoft is also adding more text action for Click to Do for AMD and Intel Copilot Plus PCs. For example, you can now select some text and you will have the options to summarize, create a bulleted list, and you can also access the rewrite feature. Also, starting with this release, Click to Do gains the Ask Copilot option that you can actually use for selected text or an object from an image, and this option will actually send whatever you selected to the Copilot app. Although this is a convenient way to interact with the Copilot app, you can always open the app and just select and paste some text or upload an image. Now, if you happen to have a computer that supports a digital pen, you can actually configure the shortcut from the pen to open Click to Do from this page. Of course, I don't have that support in this computer, so that's why you're not seeing that option on this particular page. In addition, you can also add the Click to Do option to the pen menu as one of the 4 apps that you can open through this experience. And finally, these changes for Click to Do are available for Spanish and French users in the European Economic Area. Now, if we go to the app section, we're going to find a new resume page, and basically this is a new feature which Microsoft calls it cross-device resume, which allows to continue working on OneDrive files from your iOS or Android phone on Windows 11 with a single click. So if you recently viewed or edited a Word document, Excel spreadsheet, a PowerPoint presentation, a OneNote page, or a PDF document on your phone, you will receive a notification on the desktop within 5 minutes of unlocking your PC, prompting you to resume where you left off. If you don't want to use this feature, you can turn it off right here. On the display settings section, the company is adding new HDR management features, allowing you to stream HDR video even when HDR is turned off. There is also a new option to turn on Dolby Vision independently of HDR. Also on the main display page, it's not showing on this device. However, the company is updating the label for this setting to use HDR. Now, if we go to the About page, we're going to find that under Device Specifications, Microsoft is adding a new section called Frequently Asked Questions that will provide answers to common questions about your system setup, performance, and compatibility. Now, on accessibility, the company is also updating the mouse pointer and touch page, and now it includes new mouse settings that were previously available on control panel. So, for example, in this release, you're going to find the customized pointer image that allows you to change the icon for each state of the pointer. You can also enable or disable the mouse pointer indicator. You can also now enable the mouse pointer trail from the settings app without having to use control panel, and you can also enable the mouse pointer shadow. Now, if we go to the mouse page, we're going to notice that the mouse pointer speed and enhanced pointer precision settings now include new icons. Starting with this release, network administrators can manage the Energy Saver feature from Microsoft Intune or using Group Policy. So let's just look for Group Policy. And now let's go to Computer Configuration, Administrative Templates, and then we're going to browse to the Power Management Settings. And then on Energy Saver Settings, we're going to find this new policy that allows you to control the Energy Saver feature on Windows 11. As part of the Windows 11 June 2025 update, Microsoft is also updating the search experience from the taskbar, and now the experience also works with semantic indexing. So that means that you will now be able to find settings, documents, and photos without needing to remember the exact name. This is because Windows Search now uses AI in order to understand natural language and to provide the relevant result. For example, right here I have a screenshot from a previous build where I've done a search for bear, and that pulled up an image that I have about a bear drinking coffee in a forest, and that's an image created with AI. However, on the image or in the metadata, you will find any indication that this image is about a bear. It's important to know that this feature is only available for Copilot Plus PCs. As part of the changes for the taskbar in the June 2025 update, Microsoft is rolling out new policies that allows network administrators to decide which apps users can unpin from the taskbar. Also, the company has fixed a few issues navigating with the Tab and Shift Plus Tab keyboard shortcuts. And also, if we open the Quick Settings menu, and then we go to accessibility, you will now find the option to turn on and off voice access. And finally, if you share content with the Windows Share experience, when selecting an image, you will now find an edit button that will allow you to edit the image before sending it to someone else. And some of the options include the ability to crop, make adjustments, choose from different filters, and you can also do markup on the actual image. Now, you can also select and drag a local file to the top of the screen, and that will bring a new interface that allows you to share that specific file with different applications. If you drop it into the More option, that will open the Share experience. Microsoft also notes that it's updating the context menu for the desktop to allow you to share a specific file directly to different apps. And that's it. Those are the biggest features and changes that we're going to see on the Windows 11 June 2025 update. Also, the company notes that it's fixing a bunch of issues. Now, the system will automatically download and install the update as soon as ready for everyone. However, if you want to force it or you want to install it before it is actually available for everyone, this is what you can do. First, open Start and look for Settings. Then go to Windows Update and make sure that this option is toggled on, and then click the Check for Updates button. And that will download and install the update, and it will enable all the features that are available for your computer at that time. However, some of the features and changes will take some time to turn on your computer. And that is all there is to it. Let me know in the comments what you think about these changes. Like the video, share it, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done that yet, and I just hope this video was informative for you, and I would like to thank you for viewing.